Hey guys, welcome to everyone. I'm Nad and this is my channel Rainmaking. Hey, so what I'm gonna show you today is just an extract of a very long and boring video that I'm gonna soon put online. And I thought to be better this way because you don't know what I'm aiming to. I won't add any description of what I was aiming to achieve, but you can watch it agnostically and see if there is any change in the weather that you can associate to some external source. Anyway, so what you're gonna see, it's a video composed of pictures. Each photogram is a picture that I've been taking every single day at 8 in the morning and 8 in the night to see the developing of the weather or any result of my intended manipulation. So I have to apologize for the quality of this video, which is very poor for few reasons. So first thing, as I said, each photogram has been taken in a different moment, in a different day, over an entire month. So I try to be precise, but apparently it's very hard to center the screen every time. In a few cases I had to go back on the website history and reload few of the snapshots and take another one with the same film. In doing this, I found out that you can also access to the data bank. I'm using Earth Neutral. I don't really know how to pronounce it, but I'm gonna add the link to this video here. Basically, you can go there if you want to double check the website. You'll see a shot like this. So one of the reason is that I've been taking it in different days. The second reason is that these was meant to be my photographic archive of what I've been attempting to do. I never mentioned it before, but I have about 100 videos, no, probably more than that, about 150 videos that I've been taking every time for each experiment, because I can't keep in mind everything that is happening, but they are all very crude and bare because they were meant to be only for my records. To go back to this video, I need to explain you how to read the video. So, as a first thing, the little dot on the coast, the green one, it's where my home is and where the Cloudbuster is. The green color indicates that the Reich is in function, whilst when you see a red dot, the small one I mean, it means that the Reich is turned off. Then, if it's dancing around, it's just because this kind of stuff is all new to me. When you see the big green dot, it's the direction where my ray is pointed. Then you're gonna see a few snapshots, most of them. They don't have the green big dot because it's just indicating the first adjustment that I do with the aid of a GPS pointer when I'm turning the William Reich Cloudbuster. When you see the big dot, it might disappear in the next photograms, but since this is gonna be always lit on the small circle, it means that the ray is always pointed to that point or slightly toward the winds, because I'm double checking 2, 3, 4 times a day with the winds and the GPS, and I'll readjust slightly the William Reich because we are talking about few degrees, probably even not one. When you see this box here comes up when you're pinpointing a coordinate, so I use these coordinates with my GPS pointer and I point in the machine. So I moved the William Reich. So when you see 8 a.m. it might be a quarter to 8 because I have a life. Okay, said that, at the end of the montage of these snapshots, you'll see that there is an entire week where we got 3 times the photograms. That's because the last week there was an enormous anti-cyclone in between the coast of Africa and the coast of Australia. And I wanted to understand what would happen if I pointed the ray in the very center of it, and if I could attract the entire mass to us. I will explain it later in the full video, but I try to shrink the anticyclone to a cloud and get it toward us. Another thing to say is that the distance of the big circle from my GPS location is just relative, because I can't aim with accuracy a machine that is 4 meters long to a certain point that is 6,000 kilometers away. It's just a way to be more precise with the direction of the flow, because the farther the point from my position, the more precise the measurement of the cardinal position. After you'll see the big red dot at the end, you'll see two more photograms, and that's only because I wanted to post this video as soon as I could. I'm turning off my machine now because I need to observe what's gonna happen on the month of August, which is meant to be the last month of the rain season. So we should have another month of rain coming in, but we'll see how it goes. In the longer version of the video with the full explanation, the boring one, I'm gonna add the photograms I'm gonna take in the next few days, so to see how the weather reacts without the machine on. Anyway, I will soon upload a full description of my hybrid Cloudbuster, how to assemble it and how to use it. I'm also adding the conclusion of the month of experiments video, so to give a sense of conclusion to the thing. Okay, this is all. Enjoy the video. Hey guys, how you going? Just a quick update. I thought to make a quick note about this because today is the 25th of July, so it has been an entire month of experimenting, and this has been the longest I ever go with a single experiment. Last night I turned off the machines, both of them, the two I have here, the Gin accumulator and the smaller version of the stroboscope, and the Reich Trevor Constable hybrid. So those two are off, and since last night, so by this morning, if there was any effect produced by them, that's disappeared. And now I'll show you here. So this is today, 25th of July, 8:45. I'm using earthnotion.net. You can easily access them by, where is it, there. So this little thingy here, the calendar, keeps record of every single past. So it doesn't keep in memory what's the forecast from now on, which is what I'm using to try to manipulate the weather. I just want to show you the date because so to understand, from the 25th of July 2019, my machine will be off. So we'll see how it goes. I can definitely see this area here has changed drastically. You'll see on one of the videos I'm gonna upload. So anyway, here we are. The experiments are concluded for now. I will keep the rain machine off for an entire month. So we'll see how the weather goes. At the beginning of this video, winter was going to be very dry, at least the forecast, you know. We have had an entire month of water, basically. I remember 4 clear days, all the rest, I'm gonna say 30% variable.
So at least a shower a day and a good 50% very good rain, heavy rain. So I'm not sure if we influenced the weather, but definitely we had one of the best winter ever. The website of the government shows you the record of the rains over the month, well, the average. So now here we go. This is June. Okay, this is from the Australian government of Bureau of Meteorology. So this is June 2019, and this is the average rainfall ranges. So the scale is this one. If it gets blue, is the highest in record, and that means ever. Very much above average is already a freaking good result. Above average is what we wish for every year. Average, okay, and here we go. So there are areas in Australia that in this season they are on the dry season, so the rain doesn't have to be there. So this is the area where it has to be blue, that one too. And as you can see, it has been raining very much below average in the center, so not sure what to say about that. But look at this, we are here, and as you can see, the whole area around us has had almost the record. Can't tell if, no, that's not the blue, the darker one. So very much above average. I hope the countrymen are happy. I'm joking. I'm very happy. This weather has been magnificent. My garden has exploded in a green bloom. Anyway, thanks again for watching. This is Nadir from Rain Making the Channel, and hope you enjoyed the video. This was a bit boring and blurry and whatever else. I'll do better in the future. Please consider subscribing, and see you in the next video.